What were your thoughts?
But again, without conceding much, that we lost the game in two key moments, an own goal and a set piece. We reacted really well after conceding the goal. We dominated the game. We created enough chances, at least not to lose the game. We hit the bar. I think the luck is not on our side. And at the moment, we are up against a big fight. You can sense that, but you can see how they try and the spirit there, how we are fighting, how they are trying. You cannot fault any of that. It's just at the moment, considering what we concede, that we are losing football matches. We lost against Burnley without conceding any shots on targets from the opponent. And today, the teams looks like they don't need too much, and the moment that we generate enough situations to score the goals is not happening.
That second goal was very similar to the one you conceded against Burnley as well. Does that frustrate you?
It is, because obviously they are one of the biggest team in the league, and they deliver the ball into the right area, and when that ball is in the air in that zone, it's a 50-50 ball, and they do it really well. We've been defending really well the corners, but in the last 2 weeks we have conceded two goals.
Who should have attacked it then? Who should have dealt with it?
It's not about the individual, it's a collective issue.
You say that you had chances. A few came late on, didn't it? Did you feel you had enough creativity during the game?
Well, it's really difficult when you are facing a blocked and a team that is constantly defending really low, and they are wasting time, they're playing their game. We make it difficult for ourselves, the way we concede as well the first game. And after, yeah, it's not easy to attack those spaces and have 15 chances. I think we had 13 shots, only two in targets. I think our ratio is really low. You want to be more consistently and win more football matches, but it's our reality.
Have you got players that are low on confidence? I look at your wingers, they don't seem to be getting past players. Is that down to confidence?
It's confidence, it's the opponent, is a mix of everything. And yeah, we need to generate more to win football matches. And if not, when it comes to small details, just the teams doing that little, they cannot win you the game.
You've got the fighters still, have you, in the dressing room?
Absolutely. The boys are fighting, the boys are upset, the boys are together. You can see, if not, you can sense that straight away on the pitch, and there is none of that.
It's the Cup next week. Is that a relief in a way, sort of a change of scenery? You've been so good in the Cup.
Maybe. Change competition, we've been really good on those. But we need to start winning football matches. Now the Premier League is the main priority, because we need to pick out the points straight away.
Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.
Dominic, a third win on the trot, and Everton up into second. No wonder the supporters are happy.
Absolutely, you can hear it there. I know there's only 2,000 of them, but you can hear them very loud. And I thought the performance again today, to a man, you know, we dug in. Sometimes we don't have the ball for long periods, but we never panicked and took our chances when they came.
You celebrated like you scored the goal. When did you realise it was an own goal?
Sometimes you've got to celebrate just to make everyone think it's yours, but VAR, you can't get away with that these days. So, I glanced it, and it's obviously come off the defender and gone in. So, you know, I would have liked to have gotten the score sheet, but the most important thing is the 3 points.
Crucial goal, wasn't it, just before half-time? Tell us how you worked on that. Yerry Mina looks such a danger from set pieces.
Yeah, we knew that they would be exposed in that area from set pieces, and Yerry's a massive threat in the air. So, you know, that if the delivery is on the money and he heads it, chances are he's going to score. So it was something that we had a look at, and thankfully we executed today.
And was the plan to sort of target that near post?
I would say so, yeah. Yeah, from corners, to just look where perhaps their weaknesses are and make it one of our strengths. And thankfully, like I say, we got the goal from it today.
Carlo Ancelotti's first year in charge. He says you're about where he wants you to be. What can you achieve in his second year?
I think just more of the same. You know, there's still more to come from me. I'm still kind of learning my craft and honing my game into, you know, making it better in certain aspects. So, you know, some things I'm good at, some things I can work on. So it's just about taking it all in and continuing the goal-scoring form, but most importantly, making sure week in, week out, I'm consistent in everything that I do. And I thought, you know, today, bar a goal, I've done all right.
You picked up a yellow card. What was that all about?
I actually didn't see that the board had gone up, so he was saying, you're going off, but I never saw my number go up, and then he booked me, and then it was handbag, so...
We're supposed to believe that, are we? well done today. Not a goal, but a win and second place. Congratulations.
Nice one, thank you.
So that's now 3 wins on the spin, but wins against Chelsea, Leicester and Arsenal. Phil, that's pretty good.
It's impressive. We said during the break there, the win against The win against Chelsea, the win tonight was in front of their home fans. They've not had home fans for a long time. And there's a little bit of a swagger and a confidence and a belief. And I think he's not scored for three games. And it's coincided with a little bit of change of tactics, sitting a little bit deeper. And he's had to play a team game, even though he wants to score goals. And he's worked his socks off Calvert-Lewin. He's someone that when the season gets into that after Christmas where he'll need to keep scoring goals and he'll get more chances. But for the moment, he's playing for the team and the team are defending fantastically.
And part of the season so well. They went through a little bit of a wobbly patch where they didn't. They took 4 points from six games. Now they've found their form again. In stark contrast, we've got Arsenal. One win in 10 and 15th in the table is just not where you would expect to see Arsenal.
No, you wouldn't expect them to be there, but at the moment, especially with them not firing, not creating, it's not a massive surprise that they are where they are. I think what we saw, especially with the goals tonight and the way they're playing, again, you know, not a lot of creation. And even when they did, there weren't enough people in the box. But what you want is, if you're not scoring enough, then you want to make sure that you're defending resolutely. You've got to be tighter on people. I thought that the set-piece goal was poor. I thought that the lead-up to their first goal could have been avoided, and all about just hard work, getting close to people, making it more difficult for them, because Arsenal going through a phase at the moment where they do not seem to be able to create the kind of chances that are giving them opportunities to score and giving their forwards opportunities to score. So they have to be exemplary in another area, and it's defending and being a little bit more resolute on the set-pieces, because that was far too easy. Pepe marking Mina, you know, when you've got David Luiz and Rob Holding in it. Those are the kind of small margins what you've got to do to stop those things happening. And it's not happening at the minute.
When you think of the team that Mikel Arteta has, we always say they're lacking creativity, they're lacking that spark. Can he bring that out of those players, do you think?
Well, I think that he, like I said, we said at the start of the show, he'd done that at the start of the season. Maybe it was that new manager bounce and everybody was quite enthusiastic about the tactics and what was going on. But what I think we've seen with these players is that a lot of them are not good enough to sustain what he wants. Yes, in the one-off games, in the games that we had with the FA Cup final and the way they've done, what they've done in the semi-finals and the finals, it works brilliantly. But what it's shown is that he hasn't got the calibre of player to continue to play at a consistent level. And you've got young players who are coming into a team that are struggling and it can have an effect on them. Like I mentioned, Gabriel, Saka, Eddie Nketiah, Joe Willock, you know, Reece Nelson when he's fit. All these guys are coming into a team that are really struggling to do something and they've got a lot of pressure on them.
And you know what? It's very easy, especially in the climate we're in.
Yeah.
We're always quick to call out the manager. I think some people have said, you know, Arteta needs to do more. But actually, when you look at this team, do you feel those players just need to do more when they're out there?
100%. You look at what happened when he came in. You look at the tactics today, defending deep, resolute, solid. That's what they were like. And then on the counter-attack, they had Lacazette, they had Aubameyang, who would produce moments of magic, but they had a great spirit. I don't see that spirit now in these group of players. I don't see that resolute. I think Wrighty hits it right on the head when he says, you have to be excel at one thing. I think when he came in, they were excelling at a lot of different things. Defending, they kept clean sheets, they scored on the counter-attack. Today, they didn't keep clean sheet. And on the counter-attack, I never thought at any moment, apart from the last 2 minutes, three, 4 minutes, they showed any kind of desire to want to go and win a game, to score a goal. And I think that must be a big concern. This is not a Mikel Arteta problem, even though it will be his problem. Then players, ultimately, are just not good enough to sustain the level of consistency.
They're going to have to, for me, Bill, they're going to have to. I think they've come out and backed him, and they rightly so. Yeah. He's a good coach, and they're going to have to do something for him in January. Because I think with the current players he's got, I'm not saying Arsenal are going to go down. Of course I'm not saying that. Mm. But it's the kind of form where if you can't arrest that kind of, like, slide, you will get dragged in. And then you're going to have to be under... Then you're going to be under real pressure to get yourselves out of it. Then people have to perform to a certain level to get yourselves out of it, because other teams can smell that blood and they will go for you. It's a very ruthless league, Seema.
Yeah.
I think when you see the league table, you see Southampton, Leicester up there, Everton in second. Arsenal are at that level with these. Arsenal are every bit as good as Everton, or Arsenal are every bit as good as Southampton and Leicester, because I watched Leicester the other night. Mm. Arsenal have still got those types of players. Those players need to start performing. Yeah. I think it's easy just to say Mikel Arteta this, Mikel Arteta or the manager. These players have to start performing to their absolute maximum. Yeah. Aubameyang, Willian, Pepe. Pepe and Willian tonight could easily, in the positions that they got to, have been match winners. They weren't, and they need to start performing.
It's interesting because both of you have played for clubs in big dressing rooms before, and we talk about leaders, we talk about that mentality. Tony Adams, Martin Keown, Vieira, the types of players that you played with, they don't have that sort of character in that dressing room. If you had that sort of mentality and personality, do you think it would help to bring more out of these players?
I think it's a different time, it's a different era. And I always find it very... I find it uncomfortable going back to, say, oh, the leaders and that. I think that it's personal pride in your performance. You want to play for the team, what the manager sees in you to pick you to play in that team. And that's all you should be worried about. People are talking about leaders. When you're on there, you do your job. Yes, the captain's going to lead and can't tell you where to go and do and tell you push in here and this and that. But in the main, you just want you as a player to do your particular job. I remember the last thing Tony Adams would say before he went out, every single game is do your job. And that is, you know, do your job and put in a pride in your performance.
And I think what Wright is saying there is absolutely right, is that when you've got a defensive corner, if your job is to mark Yerry Mina, do your job. Mark Yerry Mina, block him. If your job is to go and attack the ball from that corner, go and attack the ball. And I don't want to single out Pepe, but what I saw from him and Willian tonight was players that weren't taking responsibility for their own performance. Poor crosses, sloppy passes. Even when, I think we're going to highlight it in a minute, when the ball's on the left-hand side, get in the box to try and score a goal. That is the basics. That is what Everton are doing. They're doing the basics of football that actually when you go onto a field, you step over that white line, run hard, work hard, put the absolute maximum determination to try and win a game of football. And I think I saw tonight that at times Pepe was just 17 yards out, 20 yards out when the ball's on this side. That is not actually going to help your team get from 15th in the league. Arsenal Football Club, 15th in the league. If Newcastle win tonight, they go what? I think that's another 6 points. That is a real big worry for us.